Now friends, we are going to see about the potential energy. So basically potential energies come due to work done, okay, and we find the work done W is equal to G M E M by Re for earth surface when we are taking any small mass particle of mass M from infinity to the surface of earth, or for any not for the earth surface, we are taking for any big mass particle. If we are taking a small m mass at a distance from the center r, so we can write g m e m by r. So one thing that is quite that's create a little bit confusion, so I want to clear that. Look, when I am taking this m mass particle from infinity towards the mass m, so basically this mass m already applied force of attraction on this, and that is force of attraction g m m by m at a distance x is x square. So it means this system wants by itself, this mass will come at this point, okay, but potential energy is always stored whenever we are doing work done against the system, okay. So it means potential energy is the work done when we are taking the small m mass particle from distance r to infinity. So here we are using minus sign, okay. So this is the potential energy formula. Now you just go through with the formula gmm by r, okay. So once again, just for your revision, whenever we are doing work done against the system, look, this system already wants this mass come towards the capital M because force of gravitational attraction. But whenever we do work done against the system, means if we are taking this small m mass from this point to infinity, that is stores in the form of potential energy. Okay. Now, this is the formula. Now, what is the work done? How we'll use this formula? Look, there are various use of this formula, and quite later we'll see. Now we are going to observe, if somebody say I am making a system of three mass particle, like three mass particle arranged at the corners of equilateral triangle of side A, okay, so what is the potential energy of whole system? So it's too much easy. Potential energy we are finding by making number of maximum possible pairs. For this one pair, this m1 m2, second pair is m2 m3, third pair is m3 m1. So how many potential energy? First minus g m1 m2 by a, second minus g m2 m3 by a, and third minus g m3 m1 by a. If somebody asks what is the net potential energy of whole system, so we are going to add them all. So u net is what? U1 plus u2 plus u3. So u net is what? Minus sign I am taking common, and g by a also I am taking common from both, from all three, sorry. So what we get inside, we are getting m1 m2 m2 m3 m3 m1, okay. Whenever you seeing lecture, if you are getting any problem in any out of the point, so you can see, means by taking backward, going again with the lecture, or if you have still any doubts, so you can ask freely, okay. Now this is the potential energy of whole system. Now the another question, sometimes question will ask like this: how much work is done, how much work is done to separate these particles, these particles, to a distance, means they are again making equilateral triangle, but now this time the side will be 2a. So now this time this side will be 2a. M1, M2, M3. So now what's the question wants? Question want how much work is done in making a system from a triangle of A side to a triangle of 2A side. So look what you do. So firstly you find the potential energy of first system, initial system. Now secondly you will find the potential energy of second system. So if I am doing directly, which thing is change only? That is 2A. So what I am writing? U final, and it is U initial. It is U initial. So U final is what? Directly if I am writing, so minus G by 2A, because everything is remain same, only distance is changed. So this why M1, M2, M2, M3, then M3, M1. Now look, now what we will do for finding the potential energy, so for finding the work done. Okay, so how much work is done by U in making a system from this of triangle side A to a triangle of side 2A. So what we will do? U final minus U initial. Okay, so what is U final? That is minus G by 2A. M1, M2 plus M2, M3 plus M3, M1 minus, and this also contains minus, so minus minus become plus. So G by A, M1, M2. Look, this also contain minus. Okay, so minus minus become this side plus. M1, M2, M2, M3, M3, M1. So now, which thing will take common? So look, this thing is common. G by A is common. So and I'm taking G by A and M1, M2, M2, M3, M3, M1. What is inside? Minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So what we get? Plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. So what is now how much work is done by you? That is G, that's plus 1 by 2 is coming outside, so it's become G by 2A. So how much work is done by you? G by 2A. M1, M2, M2, M3, M3, M1. Now, another type of question we'll see. Suppose that I am giving you this time is square. Okay, and I want the potential energy of this system of side A. So potential energy is what? I'm going to write directly. Potential energy is basically the summation of maximum possible pairs of individual their pair energies. So how many pairs? So firstly I'm going to write, so which thing I'm taking common? So look, minus G, step by step I will do, otherwise you will get confused. Okay, so firstly I am finding for one, first one U1 minus G M1 M2 by A. What is U2? This pair. Minus G M2 M3 by A. U3 minus G M3 M4 by A. U4 minus G M1 M4 by A. Okay, now another any pair. So what I said, maximum possible pairs. What I said, maximum possible pairs. So now look, this pair is remaining M1 to M3, M2 to M4. Okay, so what is this? M5 minus G M1 M3. Now what is the separation? Look, this is A, this is A. So by Pythagoras theorem, it is A root 2. So A root 2. What is U6? Similarly, minus G M2 M2 M 4 by a root 2. Okay, now what is u net? Minus g a, I am taking common inside m1 m2 m2 m3 m3 m4 m1 m4 then plus m1 m3, I am taking a common, so inside root 2 plus m2 m4 root 2, this is u net. Okay, now further we'll see what is the use of this potential energy. Now look here, after knowing the potential energy, one more thing. Suppose that if I am giving you here, if I am giving you a cube, and every corner has mass m, so how you find the potential energy of this system? Firstly, we have to see how many maximum possible pairs. For that, what we have to do? So look, if you are going to think like this, one pair, two pair, three pair, four pair, five pair, six pair, then again this m mass having pair with this mass, 1 2 3 4, okay, and sometimes you get confused. Okay, so how we'll know? For that, here we are going to know one mathematical rule. Okay, so NCR, firstly we'll understand this is n factorial, r factorial, n minus r factorial. It will tell the number of possible pairs. Okay, so don't be afraid. Now I'm going to tell you about everything. N is number, it is from how many things. R is of how many things we make pair, like this. How many masses are? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here we are going to put, now here we are going to put 8. How many, taking in consideration, we are going to make pair? 2. Because pair is of 2. 1, 1, 2, then 1, 2, like this. So here we are going to write 2. Okay. Now how we use this? Okay. So look. So firstly, I will make you. By taking simple example. One more thing, what is factorial? That is the sign of factorial. So like 3 factorial. 3 factorial means 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, 4 factorial. It means 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, so as I said, as we saw here, when 4 mass particles, so how many pairs are come? 6. Okay, now we'll check by this formula, is the number of pairs are coming 6? So m1, m2, m3, m4. So now, how many things we have? 4. In this formula, I am going to put. Out of which, how many taking consideration we have to make pair? 2. Now I am going to put in this formula. It is 4 factorial upon 2 factorial upon 4 minus 2 factorial, that is 4 factorial 2 factorial into 2 factorial. Now I'm going to write 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Similarly, 2 into 1, 2 into 1, cancel, 3 to 6. So how many pairs we get here? 6. Okay, now similarly, if we want to know how many maximum possible pairs here possible, so how many things we have? 8. Out of taking how much taking consideration we have to make pair? 2. So 8 factorial, 2 factorial, 8 minus 6 factorial by this formula. Okay, 8 factorial, 2 factorial, it's become 8 minus 6, how much? 2 factorial. 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 3 into 2 into 1, सॉरी 4 इज मिसिंग सो आई एम राइटिंग एट लास्ट 4 ओके 8 6 7 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 1 ओके 2 into 1 2 into 1 सो अगेन दिस कैंसिल आउट स्टूडेंट्स बाई मिस्टेक आई एम राइटिंग हेयर 6 बेसिकली हेयर 2 आई फॉरगेट हेयर इट इज आर ओके सो दिस इज 8 माइनस 2 फैक्टोरियल इट्स हाउ मच फैक्टोरियल 6 फैक्टोरियल सो अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू राइट दिस ओके बाई मिस्टेक आई एम राइटिंग हेयर 6 सो 8 माइनस 2 बाई दिस फॉर्मूला आर इज 2 ओके सो 8 फैक्टोरियल अपॉन 2 फैक्टोरियल 6 फैक्टोरियल सो वॉट आई एम गोइंग 8 फैक्टोरियल 2 फैक्टोरियल एंड 6 फैक्टोरियल दिस आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सपेंड दैट इज 8 इंटू 7 इंटू 6 इंटू 5 इंटू 4 इंटू 3 इंटू 2 इंटू 1 एंड बिलो 1 2 इंटू 1 इंटू 6 इंटू 5 इंटू 4 इंटू 3 इंटू 2 इंटू 1 दिस होल कैंसिल आउट 2 4 सो हाउ मेनी मैक्सिमम पॉसिबल पेयर्स 28 Okay, we can solve this shortly by this. If below 1, any big number factorial, so we can cancel like this. 8 into 7 into 6 factorial, we can write this. And below 2 factorial into 6 factorial, this cancel out as usual by opening and by direct we can cancel. Then 2 into 1 is 2, so 4. So we can get the answer directly also. Okay, this is the trick by which we know how many maximum possible pairs in a system possible. Okay. Now we are going to see binding energy. Okay, what do you understand by binding energy? Okay, so look, suppose that a servant take from his owner in advance, suppose that 50,000 rupees. Okay, and he has his salary of 5,000 per month. Okay, just for example. Okay, so if that servant is not able to give that money in return, so that servant's energy is in negative. That servant is in loss of minus 50,000 and he has to do work under his owner till 10 months. Okay, understand? Okay, so what I'm going to see here, it is the 50,000 when he was taking, so when he was not able to return, so at that time that's energy is that money that he took, it's become negative for him. Okay, now if he is not able to return that money to the owner, so he has to be stay with the same owner till long life. Okay, now similarly, why I'm telling this story, if suppose that anything is any person of mass m is over the surface of earth and it is and mass of earth we consider at the center, so how much distance from the center it is r, so how we write the potential energy of the person, so potential energy having minus sign g m e m by r e, this minus sign denotes this person or every person, we are all mass particles or mass person, mass having person, so every person having this amount of energy negative. Okay, if we want to going outside of the earth, okay, so we have to take this much energy. When we have this much energy, we are getting this much energy in positive, so net energy on ourselves becomes zero, then we are able to lose the gravitational surface or gravitational field. Okay, now look, so this energy in positive form, if somebody asks what is binding energy, so this energy we are in loss of, because minus sign denotes negative loss. So we are in loss of this amount of energy. This is our binding energy, basically. Okay, and somewhere this is also our escape energy. Escape energy. If we want to lose gravitational surface, so Earth's gravitational surface, somebody has to give us this amount of energy in positive form. So net energy on us becomes zero. Then we are able to leave the Earth's surface. Okay. Now question will ask: if you want to lose, you want to come out of the gravitational field of the Earth. So you have somebody has or by any machine, you have to take this amount of energy. But this amount of energy you are taking in the potential energy form. Never. You want to escape the Earth's surface. So this energy is given to you in the form of kinetic energy. Okay. So now we are going to see the escape velocity. Okay. So escape velocity is the amount of velocity is given to anybody by which it leaves the surface of the Earth. Okay. So this energy when gives in the form of potential energy, then we getting the means then we are going outside the surface of the Earth or gravitational field of the Earth. Okay, so this energy is given us in the form of kinetic energy. So what we write, half m, that velocity at that time, the velocity is given to us, that is ve, escape velocity is equal to g me re m. Mm cancel out. Now this ve become gme 2 times of gme re. Now from the relation of small g and capital G, that is acceleration due to gravity and universal gravitational constant, what we write, small g is equal to gme by re square. So from this relation, at the place of gme, what we can write, g re square. Now I'm going to put here. So when I'm going to put here, what we get, ve 2 g re square by re, cancel out. Okay, so what is ve? Under root 2 g re. Okay, now we know the value of both g and re. So what is the value of g? G value is 9.8 meter per second square, and re value is 6400 kilometer. Okay, now when we are going to put this value in this expression, so then we get the escape velocity 11.2 kilometer per second. Okay, approximate we are getting this. So when anyone give us this velocity, then we are able to leave the Earth gravitational surface. Okay, one more thing you have to remember is this velocity, that is under root 2 gre, is depend on the mass of the any person. It's never depend on the mass of the any person. So escape velocity is not depend on the mass, it's only depend on the acceleration due to gravity and radius of the Earth. Okay, now suppose that now we are going to talk about the satellite. Okay, now we are going to talk about the satellite. Now suppose that it's our Earth or any planet. Okay, we are calculating for any general. Okay, suppose that it having mass m, and another small m mass particle or satellite is rotating about this. Okay, now you will tell me, I'm going to calculate the orbital velocity first. Okay, I'm going to calculate the first orbital velocity in this orbit from how much velocity it's rotated. So how many force working over it? Two forces definitely, that is one is gravitational force, another is centrifugal, that is orbital velocity square, and that this distance we are taking from the center, we are taking r. Okay, so what we write, fg is equal to f centrifugal force. Okay, fg is what, gmm आर आई एम टेकिंग फ्रॉम द सेंटर, आर स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू एम वी नॉट स्क्वायर, एम एम कैंसिल आउट आर, आर कैंसिल एंड दिस वी नॉट बिकम अंडर रूट जी एम बाई आर. इट्स फॉर जनरल. ओके नाउ इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द अर्थ, इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द अर्थ, सो वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द अर्थ, सो वन थिंग यू हैव टू बी इन कंसिडरेशन, वन वी आर टेकिंग अर्थ रेडियस आर एंड फ्रॉम द अर्थ सर्फेस वी आर टेकिंग हाइट एच. ओके सो दिस आर बिकम दिस टाइम आर ई प्लस एच. ओके एंड मास बिकम एम ई. सो वॉट इज द ऑर्बिटल वेलोसिटी ऑफ एनी प्लेनेट विच रोटेट्स अबाउट अवर अर्थ, दैट इज सॉरी एनी सैटेलाइट, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द सैटेलाइट, सो इट इज आर ई प्लस एच. ओके we are taking, we are going to take some consideration. If r is very very less than re, so it means re plus h approximately is equal to re. So what is v naught? Orbital velocity of that satellite which is very close to earth surface. So that is g m e upon re. So at the place of GME, again what we can write at the place of GME from the relation g is equal to GME by RE square. So at the place of GME we can write GRE square. Now I'm going to put here. So when I'm going to put here GRE square, RE RE cancel, it's become under root GRE. Okay. So this is the formula of that orbital satellite which is very close to Earth's surface. Now, if somebody asks, what is the relation between the escape velocity of Earth and orbital velocity of Earth? What is the relation between the escape velocity of Earth and orbital velocity of Earth? So, what is the relation? Look, what is the escape velocity? Under root 2GRE. And what is the orbital velocity? Under root GRE. So, if I am taking the both ratio, VE upon V naught, so it's root 2 GRE upon GRE, this will cancel out and this will come root 2. So escape velocity is root 2 times of orbital velocity. Okay. Now we want to calculate the time period. We want to calculate the time period of a satellite. Okay. So again, we know the orbital velocity, that is how much? Root gm upon r. R time period of satellite, I am not saying for the earth, for earth we are taking r is equal to re plus h and m is equal to me. I am talking about a general. Okay, so orbital velocity is root gm by r. What is the formula of speed? Speed is equal to what? If any planet or any satellite rotates and we are taking in the consideration the rotation is of approximate circular, so what we write? V naught 2 pi r by t, so that is gm by r. So what is t? T is basically 2 pi r gm. Okay, now for earth surface, okay, now if I am talking about the earth surface, so r changes to re plus h, I am going to put here. So t is equal to what? 2 pi, this we are writing re plus h and re plus h gm, or this also we can write like this, t is equal to 2 pi re plus h power 3 by 2 and gm e, that is mass of earth, power 1 by 2. Now again, if satellite very closer to earth, closer to Earth, then if satellite is very closer to Earth, at that time Re plus H become is equal to Re. So how we can write? 2 pi Re inside Re GME. Then again at the place of GME, what we can write? At the place of GME, we can write GRE square. This will cancel out. Then 2 pi. This Re, step by step I am going, otherwise you get confused. Now when this Re is going inside of the under root, so it's become twice, means in multiplication. So it is what? Re into Re upon GRE. This cancel out. So what is the time period of that satellite which is very closer to Earth? That is 2 pi under root Re by G. Okay, 2 pi under root Re by G. Okay, we know the value of both Re and G, so whenever we solve this we are getting 84.6 minute, and that is approximate 1.4 hours. Okay, and one thing I forget, whenever I am, this also we can know, because G value and Re value both we know. So what is the orbital velocity of that satellite which is very close to Earth? That is approximate 8 kilometer per second. Okay, now we are going to see binding energy of satellite. Binding energy of satellite, it's too much easy. Okay, so look, M mass, and this is satellite and it's rotated. So how many energies this satellite have? Two energies, simple, kinetic energy as well as potential energy. Okay, so potential energy, for finding the total energy, or we'll say binding energy, so we have to find kinetic and potential first. Okay, so potential energy is what? Minus, if this separation is R, so potential is minus G M M by R. Now the turn off for finding the kinetic energy. So for finding the kinetic energy, M mass is rotating, so how many force working? Two forces, Fg or F centrifugal. So what is Fg? G M M by R square is equal to M V naught square, that is orbital velocity, upon R. This cancel out. So G M by R M V naught square. What is the formula of kinetic energy? Half M V square. If I am multiplying both sides by half, so this is become the kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is equal to half G M M by R. I am going to put here, I know the both values. So what is the total energy or binding energy of satellite? That is kinetic plus potential, that is half G M M by R minus G M M by R. So minus half G M M by R. So look, if we talk about the binding energy, we are taking plus sign. Okay, we are taking plus sign. Okay, if we are, somebody asks me total energy, we are taking minus sign. Total energy is negative, and by what amount of energy we are bounded, that is only magnitude they are asking. Okay, that is half G M M by R. If we are getting this much energy, means if we are getting half G M M by R in positive form, means if satellite getting, sorry, so this total energy become zero, and this satellite is going out of the gravitational field of the dead planet. Okay, so this is the binding energy. Okay, I am not writing here, otherwise you get confused. Total energy is this, and binding energy is the positive of this. Okay, now we are going to see the weightlessness in the satellite. Now we are going to see the weightlessness in the satellite. So for that, suppose that it is a planet. Weightlessness in a satellite. Okay, this is a planet, and this is the I am making the surface of the spaceship, and here a man is standing. Okay, so this making a, and that man is inside the satellite, and it's rotate, that satellite is rotate. So this man having mass m. So how many force working over this man? One is gravitational force, another is normal reaction, and another is centrifugal, that is outside, that is mv naught square by r. Okay, so what I am going to write, fg gravitation is equal to normal reaction plus mv naught square r. Okay, fg is what? G m m by r square, okay, is equal to n plus v naught. What we are finding, v naught, that is under root g m by r. I am going to put here m r as usual, so under root, that is g m by r, under root square cancel out. Okay, v naught value I am writing inside here, otherwise you get confused. Okay, so this and this become both equals, so g m m by r square, this side this come, so g m m by r square normal reaction. So normal reaction become zero. Okay, so whenever there is a normal reaction zero, you always remember there is weightless, or where there we feel we don't have any weight. Okay, that's why inside the satellite astronomers feel weightless. Okay.